you went through most of it.
Emma Collins looks like your typical 16-year-old girl now. But less than 3 years ago, she was dying of cancer. 7-year-old Kashawn Lawhorn was facing the same fate.
You were good? Brave?
Brave.
Kashawn and Emma were both battling leukemia, and for both, traditional treatments, chemotherapy and radiation, weren't working. But a game-changing experimental cancer treatment that utilizes the body's own immune system gave them a second chance.
I mean, the immune system's developed over many, 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 you know, over millions and billions of years to actually get rid of things that don't belong in the body. Cancer doesn't belong there.
Dr. Stephen Grupp is the director of immunotherapy at the Children's Hospital of Philadelphia, where Kashawn and Emma took part in a clinical trial for this revolutionary treatment.
We collect white blood cells from the patient. Those include T cells. Those T cells then go to a specific place where they are manufactured, reprogrammed to actually be able to attack cancer cells.
These souped-up cells, now called CAR T cells, are then put back in the body, says Dr. Shannon Maud, where they multiply and get to work.
When they find something that they recognize, like the B cell leukemia, they kill that off.
If you had told me 5 years ago how effective they would be, I wouldn't have believed you.
Better yet, some of the CAR T cells, says Chief of Oncology Dr. Stephen Hunger, may actually stick around to fight any recurrence.
They said that he was doing good and they couldn't find any signs of leukemia.
It took just one T cell treatment to finally put Kashawn's cancer into remission.
Everything worked out good and I'm healthy.
Just 4 days after Emma's T cell treatment, there was no sign of her cancer.
Out of many, many years of many people doing a lot of work to come to this point. It's really exciting.
The CAR T therapy is effective mainly against leukemia and lymphoma, but researchers are working to also use it against so-called solid tumors like breast, colon, and lung. While not all patients have their cancer destroyed, the trials have been positive enough that the FDA is expected to approve the therapy this year. Dr. Max Gomez, CBS 2 News.